Great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Michigan State Spartans and the Virginia Cavaliers. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
There are two solid power forwards that will be matched up against one another. Yes, it'll be a treat to watch them battle on both ends of the court. They both have the potential to take control of the paint and the game.
All right, guys are in position and we're ready for the tip. So here we go. The Spartans, number two in the polls right now, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing. To be in the top 25, you better be able to focus and to really respond to the challenges that you face.
The Spartans set up in their zone motion. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He goes up with it. Bust the J.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Bust the jumper. They work it around the perimeter, puts up the tray. Jumper won't go. The small forward receives the pass.
Look at that spacing.
Loose ball and batted in. Gave it up. Pushing in transition. Jumper off the mark. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. On the right side. He tries the jumper. They got it. The chanting continues.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Dick, they're ripping up the nets tonight.
And they're definitely shooting the ball well tonight. Great execution by these boys.
On the dribble, gives it up. He attempts the trifecta. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's doing it all right now for this team. It'll be interesting to see if he can keep this up.
Swatted away. Can't get the shot. Rejected. He misses the jumper. Two makes the shot. And the slam.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. Makes it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He shoots from the deep corner. The missed shot. Harris receives the pass. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Here's the three ball. That's not a good shot given his abilities.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
They move it into the front court.
A
Looks at a three. Oh, yes. Throws it up. He rejects it. He makes the block. Now they work it around the perimeter. Takes his jumper. Knocked it down. Looking for a good shot. And now the fadeaway jumper. Missed it. For two, he gets it to fall. Takes it strong to the hoop.
I tell you, you know I like the way this kid uses his body, Brad. He's the type of guy you want in your roster. When you want that inside presence, his size and power is an asset.
He shoots from the corner. And score it. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Work it around the arc. Goes up for two. He doesn't get the hoop. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Three balls paying dividends tonight, Dick.
That's right, Brad. All their bills are getting paid from the arc, baby.
On the outside. Here's a double team for the bucket. 8 minutes left in the game clock. Sinks the shot. We're ready to get back to the action. The Cavaliers are going into their zone motion offense now. They work it around the perimeter. He attempts the jump shot.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Looking for a good shot.
I think right now, got to focus defensively.
Can't connect. Harris handles the pass. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I love the four.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Moving it around the perimeter. From the corner. Missed the jumper. Gave it up. stop and pop. Man, Dick, they are making scoring here look impossible.
That's a horrific, awful, terrible, poor, appalling. I'm absolutely embarrassed, Brad. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He goes for three. Off the mark. From downtown. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
We're at the six-minute mark. They work the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. Nails the jumper. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Can't get the shot to go. Braswell receives the ball. On the outside. Dick, they really need to get something going in a hurry here.
Yeah, call a timeout and get your boys into the game, Brad. Up and inside.
He throws it up from downtown. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He puts up the tray. Nope. Jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. Mitchell is recognized as a player who can do it all down there on the low block.
They like his game because he can play with his back toward the basket and he can shoot it from 12 to 15 feet.
And come up short. Inside. Takes the fadeaway jumper. He misses the fadeaway.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
They work it around the perimeter. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. From the baseline. And he missed. Goes in.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
The small forward takes the feed. They got it.
Trying to go inside.
He shoots the jumper. Off the mark. Harris handles the feed.
Look at that spacing.
From beyond the arc. Knocked it down. Tries for two. Great shot. About 3 minutes remaining. And a momentary look from three-point land. From the corner. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
For two. No. Harris handles the feed. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And we'll get a change of possession. You know, Dick, this guy's really elevated his game today.
He's been playing like he has one thing on his mind. Winning. He's been doing whatever it takes to get baskets and stops. We'll have to wait and see if that translates into a win here today.
At home. out on the wing. Now they work it around the perimeter. About 2 minutes remaining. There's a double team waiting there. And the ball out of bounds, but we'll be staying right here. They'll throw this one in from the side. 8 seconds. And it's blocked. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots killed chemistry, Brad.
He hammers it home. Did a great job of getting to the hoop on that one, Richard.
That's a great take, Brad. That puts pressure on the defense when you go to the hoop like that.
He shoots from outside. Can't connect. Looking for a good shot. He puts up the J. Nails the J. 1 minute left on the game clock.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The missed shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. He can't get the bucket to fall. They'll work it around the arc. There's the block. The turn, a fadeaway jumper. There's a very tight lid on that rim for him right now, Dick.
That's right, Brad. Nothing seems to be dropping.
Mitchell handles the feed. Working it around the perimeter. With the J. Missed the jumper. That one's off. He fires from long range. No good. At the end of the first half, the Spartans are trailing by two. Virginia has made a statement by crashing the boards in the first half, Dick.
Very, very strong statement. They're letting the opposition know that they're not going to give them any second chance opportunities. And that speaks volumes, baby.
Going with a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
Isn't it great, Brad?
On the outside. Goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. He knocks down the jumper. Looking for a good shot. From the corner. Off the mark. Moving it around the perimeter. He launches a three. He's taken too many unnecessary shots, Dick.
And he's costing his team their rhythm.
Takes the jumper. Busts the jumper.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Well, here's the block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
They look like they're having a blast.
Lobs it. Tries for two. The shot's off target. That's good. They work the perimeter. For nice rejection. Harris handles the pass. The low block.
Great shot block right there. They had some good movement on the offensive side.
On the left side. Goes up for two. Knocks it down. Now that's how you take the ball to the basket.
Well, he spotted an opening and he just absolutely great first step and he exploded to the goal.
Gave it up. Goes up. Gets the J to fall. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Puts up the J. Jumper won't go. The dribble, gives it up for the bucket. He gets the bucket to fall. And the great defense. On the outside, looks at the three. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Hey, if it wasn't for his play, they'd be in big trouble, Brad. Someone else needs to step up.
Nope. Can you not love this game and the hoopla and fanfare that goes along with it?
It's crazy.
Blocked. Off the mark. Cross court. He looks for three. Scores it. Cross court.
There's the trap.
From the corner, scorches the net with a J.
Up and inside.
He strokes it. They get it to go.
He's just not giving the effort on defense.
He's not putting up a good fight at all. Circle. Missed it. Harris handles the feed. He shoots from the corner. Questionable shot selection there.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball. Nice step in it, man. Take a look right here. Little barista boy in shorts, little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. They work it around the perimeter. Three. Knocked it down. He puts it up, knocks it down. had a momentary look from three-point land. This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
Wow, listen to those fans. The crowd is thunderous.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Off the mark. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
We'll stay right here. These guys have really been able to step it up so far. They're putting together a very good team effort.
I tell you, it's been great to watch these kids really work one another out there. They all have individual skills to put the ball in the hoop, but that isn't always what's best for a team. Everyone needs to get touches so they can feel and bomb.
He tries the jumper. Gets the J to fall. How about that play? They went through the high post again.
You know, whether you're attacking the zone or man-to-man, getting the ball at the high post puts pressure on the defense.
How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
He has all kinds of moves, and we saw just about all of them on that drive. A good-looking 2 points.
7 minutes left on the game clock. He puts up the three ball. Missed the jumper. He gets the rejection. Nails the jumper. Now they work it around the perimeter. For two, he drains the bucket. Gave it up. Controlling the ball.
Nice low post play. Good entry to the box.
It sticks. He shoots the jumper and come up short. We're at the 6 minute mark. Looking for a good shot. From the corner.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards right there.
Yeah, that helps. And the fans are going wild.
Hey, pandemonium is in full effect.
He tries the three ball. Nails the fadeaway. And it's knocked away. Great block. They'll work it around the arc. Goes up for two. He gets the bucket. 5 minutes left in the game clock. On the dribble, gives it up. With the jumper. The missed shot. Pushes it up. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He misses the jumper. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
Working it around the perimeter. With the J, he makes the jumper. The Cavaliers might be in some trouble here, Dick. They're going to have to put the pedal to the metal and really look to attack offensively to get some baskets.
They need to get down and dirty, Brad. They should start pressing and trapping in order to force some turnovers. Time is definitely not on their side.
out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. Let's take another look at this deep three. Gave it up. The Cavaliers have a three-point shooter spotting up. On the outside, he throws it up from downtown. He misses the J. Working around the perimeter. Puts up the jumper. Busts the J. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. In the post, he puts up the J. Nope. The shooting guard receives the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the fall away. Sweet fadeaway J. The Spartans are in a great position with the time and score on their side, and they're going to have to play more in the half court now, Dick.
Hey, these guys aren't known for being a half court team. However, at this point, with the time and score where it is, it'd be smart for them to have longer offensive possessions, which keep the clock running.
Looking for a good shot. For two, with a layup. Gave it up. About 2 minutes remaining. They go into the low block. He makes the block. Number 15's mediocre play has really gotten to him.
Brad, he's in what many people call a funk. Emotionally, he's got to turn things around.
On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from a deep corner. Off the mark. Gave it up. Goes up with it, and he can't hit the shot. Valentine receives the pass. Moving it around the perimeter with a deep shot from outside. He misses the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Off the backboard. And the ball's dribbled out of bounds. For the deuce. Lays it up. That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. The Cavaliers set up into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
You need to create as many possessions as possible, so keep falling.
Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? Ball coming in from the sideline. And now getting set up here to four, round one.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
And the clock stopped with a foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Sideline inbounds. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. And the clock stopped with a foul. Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. If you're on the class, but it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
He can't get one to fall.
A bucket here is crucial.
So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
Talk about pressure and expectations from the head coaching perspective.
Hey, Brad, those two things have got a lot of coaches going gray and losing their hair, becoming bald like me, baby. I've got nothing but respect for coaches who've been successful, and I've been in the business for 20-plus years. That's an accomplishment.
We get ready to bounce back into action here. Zone offense now.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He launches a three. Missed the jumper. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Here's another solid junior.
He's been around for a couple of years now. He knows what he's capable of bringing to the team. This is a year where players start to transition into more of a leadership role and help get the most out of younger guys on the team.
Misses the second.
The basket here will make this a two-possession game.
And we're back. Dick Vitale and Brad Nessler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout. Into their zone motion now. The power forward with the ball. Oh, yes! That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
Steps to the line for the first time. He makes the front end of the one-on-one. Up and in. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. The Cavaliers are going into their zone motion offense now. He attempts the three. While we've got a moment here, Dick, let's take a look at our players of the game.
Hey, two great young players here. Both stepped up for their teams and made this game interesting.
Virginia loses in this very well-matched game.
You know, they really showed what they were made of and can come away from this game with a moral victory.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.